EA Sports. It's in the game.
Someone put me out. Searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. Fire. I can't give up about what they say. Searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. I'm at land trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buff. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go with water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibi splash. If I finally starting to realize, never give up and coexist. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? I don't got time. Infrastructure, I don't got time. I could it's all to we're talking about. Your brother protecting the sons and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to fire. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my way.
Never play by the rules, guess I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up the item you choose. Many times in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up with nothing, why the rush up with nothing. Why the rush up with nothing, why the rush up with nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, out of the execution, think I know the solution.
Today, from SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California, it's week 17 of the NFL on EA Sports. Chargers taking on Deshaun Watson and the Houston Texans.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Houston Texans and the Los Angeles Chargers.
For the Chargers.
Here we go. The final week of the NFL season, week 17, is underway. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Out comes Deshaun Watson, ready to captain the ship here for this Houston offense.
And it felt like in watching the game tape, he got everyone involved last week.
He was a manager.
He really was. That's a great way to put it, because they ran the ball some, they threw it accurately. One touchdown pass, so he didn't, you know, break the bank doing that, but he didn't throw any interceptions. That's the bottom line. That's why a defense loves a quarterback like that. Doesn't put them in bad situations.
He gets it left side to Johnson. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though.
Huh? Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
The football, and this is recovered by the Chargers. Here are the Chargers ready to go on offense, led by their first round pick in 2020, the man out of Oregon, Justin Herbert.
I love today's NFL because it is high flying, big time action, some risk involved, But how about him eliminating all that last week? Three touchdown passes, incredible yardage.
Yeah, almost 400.
Big time game.
Now Herbert following the turnover. He's going to go on top for the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
Second and 10 at the 21.
From the 21, it's second and 10. Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. And he's got four down inside the 20 to the 18.
Ball carrier.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. A shotgun snap for Herbert. He rifles one that's intercepted. But Andrick McKinney, the linebacker, picks it. And he's all the way up past the 25. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it's a second down.
A gain of a yard brings up second and nine at the 28
yard. On second and nine, Watson. Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. DeForest Buckner has now recorded 10 sacks on the season. Following the sack, it's now third and long for Watson and the Texans.
Third and 13.
A shotgun snap for Watson. He's letting this one go for four. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Well, they've moved the ball okay here in these first two drives, but this one's going to again amount to nothing. They've got to start dialing up some plays that allow them to finish drives with points.
It'll be a 10-yard return following a punt of 45, and it'll be Charger football here as they take over.
38-yard line.
Heading back out, the Chargers offense, we get a peek at the playoff picture of the AFC, and you can see it's no race for the top spot. That's been decided. These guys will hope to get through Week 17 in one piece before they host a division round game in 2 weeks' time.
And I think that what they'll do is they'll be very selective about who plays in this game, all right? There's certain guys that maybe are starters, but maybe haven't played as much as other guys during the year. Maybe they still need their timing back. Other guys, you're going to put in bubble wrap and put them on the sidelines and tell them, we'll see you in 2 weeks.
Deep down on second down, and it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And get this down to the 39-yard line. A nice pickup of 23 on the third down conversion. So finally completes his first pass. Credit the defense, though. They've been showing him some different looks, keeping him off balance.
Yeah, I like the observation that you had there, because when you give him different looks, and you give any quarterback different looks, it takes just a little bit longer to process sometimes, and you don't throw the ball with the same confidence. You're not sure that that's where you should go with the football, and that's worked for the defense early in this game. And now he's got his first completion. Let's see if his confidence comes back, and he starts to get into a nice little groove.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
It's a gain of six. Makes it third and four.
On third down, here's Ekeler. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. It's a pickup of three, but it brings up what will be an interesting fourth and one. It's a 47-yard field goal try from here, but instead they're going to opt to go for it on fourth down. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. So he needed one. He ended up getting three.
And I really like the way he ran that one, too. That's really intelligent running because oftentimes a running back could get too greedy. Try and hit the home run on a play where you just need a few yards. Well done there, making sure he got the first down and not worrying about trying to get a touchdown.
21-yard line.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 14 carries, 51 yards.
But he's the number two runner in the league, and you just know the offensive line wants to get him to number one because most of the good ball carriers, they take care of their linemen. Could be a gold watch in their future if he becomes the leading rusher.
4 yards the pickup, first down. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now left side on the swing pass, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The first down screen pass, good for five.
It's a gain of five.
They'll run for the first time here with Matt Breida. And all this Texans defense, they're all charged up now. They stop him behind the line for the second straight play. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. No score after one on EA Sports. To throw on third down. Herbert, and able to find Dorsett. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First and goal from the 6. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Didn't get the push they needed. It gets it for 4, maybe 5, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back.
Right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
A crucial penalty there as the hold backs him up for another second and goal. This is Eckler, and this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Back to throw here, Herbert. Complete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
But your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while. But when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out these long drives and get 6s instead of 3s.
So you're a boxing guy. How do you score that on your boxing card? A very long drive, but 3 points.
And I really want to do my boxing analyst voice right here, but I'm going to keep it normal for us, right? I call it a draw. That type of a drive has to feel good, right? You take it all the way downfield, you control the ball, control the clock. But then we got 3 points out of it. So defensively, it could have been worse, right? So I give it a draw.
Thank you. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll start with a handoff to Johnson. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
And they'll work from the 29 on second and 6. Running from the gun, Johnson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 11 yards there, first down.
By Derwin James.
Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
On first down, it's Watson. It's hauled up by Brandon Cooks. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
You always worry about those smaller receivers running through that gnarly patch of land in the middle of the field. But he did a really nice job there holding on to the football and protected himself as best he could while completing the play.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. From the gun, a run for Johnson. He'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 31. 7 yards there and a first down. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. From the gun, here's Watson. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10.
Leads to second and 10.
Throwing again is Watson. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. And he showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
The Charger D making things difficult, and it's fourth down.
It's now fourth down.
They run. It's Johnson. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. Just enough push up front. He only needed about 6 inches. He didn't get a whole lot more than that.
No, but he made sure he got enough so they didn't have to worry about measuring it or making it even close. Ends up picking up a couple of yards in a situation, as you noted, where he only needed inches.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing again, Watson. It's caught, Stills, right side. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And he finds Stills, complete. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Watson looks to throw again. This will be caught at about the 5. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5. And that catch, he just hit number 800 in his NFL career.
And just think, that puts you in top 35 range. all-time in the NFL in terms of number of catches. One significant guy in that number, Shannon Sharp, who was a tight end. That's big-time play right there.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Out of the gun, Watson. The LA defense up the snuff in coverage there. Pushes this to fourth down. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
That ties the game at 3-3.
That drive just seemed to go for an eternity. I could kind of hear our sponsor saying, hey, we need to get our product pushed here. But then it ends in a field goal.
Yeah, how about that? Not enough time for product placement, but plenty of time to get 3 points out of the deal. I know that the guys on defense, though, they wanted to get those products out there. They wanted to stop that drive, just were unable to do so.
At their own 24.
Here comes the Chargers offense now back out onto the field. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. A couple completions, just string them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
The Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Just an incompletion here.
At the 20,
from the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. And they get this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards the pick up there. First down now, but that clock rolling.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Play action. It's Herbert. Deep ball for Goodwin. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Chargers take over first and 10.
The attention shifts back to Justin Herbert and the Chargers offense. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, not get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little, kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. Once more, here's Eckler. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line. Scrimmage
brought down right at the line of scrimmage.
And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. He finds Dorsett. It's complete. Philip Dorsett by himself. Touchdown, LA. Philip Dorsett.
his sixth touchdown of the season, and the Chargers have taken the lead. And sometimes those slants, they can be so tough to defend after the catch. It just happens so quickly.
And really, what gets set up there is how quickly everything happens. Ball's out of the hands of the passer in a hurry, and he just takes it and goes.
He went all the way into the end zone. Taken about 7 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. So here's the Texans' offense now. They get set to start this third quarter. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching it point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back.
Question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. Third quarter action here, this regular season finale. This will be second and 10. To throw again, Watson. Looking outside, and he's got a man. It's Johnson. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. Again, it's Watson. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And that is incomplete.
Well, coming into this one, we expected that this offense would have trouble with this defense, and that's exactly the way that this game has gone. Pressure in his face, coverage downfield has been tight. That led to another incompletion. This defense, they're exactly who we thought they were coming into this one.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
Come on, are you serious?
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. From his own end zone, Herbert. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Incomplete.
Third quarter now from SoFi Stadium. Here's a second and 10. To throw from his end zone. Herbert, he'll air this one out deep for Perriman. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. He was looking for Breshad Perriman, but now it's third down.
All right, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. Third and long coming up, back near your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for it.
Herbert, his third interception. It's J.J. Watt. And did he get in? No, they'll mark him down at the one-yard line. Bill, from their own two, Charles, they opted to throw it instead of run it. We saw the outcome.
I think what a lot of teams count on is defenses to stack the line of scrimmage, trying to force a seat.
And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Greg Olsen with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only one play to score. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Here's a Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession.
And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
On second down, a run with Breida. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. The Texans here on third down putting an extra defender in the secondary. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. And his pass is intercepted for the third time. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Complete to
second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down.
Second and 5 at the Chargers' 36-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Watson. Throw left side complete. It's Fuller. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
To Will Fuller.
19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
First down.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Watson to give. This is Johnson. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown.
The ball carry.
Duke Johnson touchdown, with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Texans turn that interception into a touchdown. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd, and they asked for halftime adjustments and all that was going on. And remember what I said. It's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes just remembering the game plan and playing better, tuning it up and just working through it methodically, they got it done in this case.
Of course, I'll always remember that appearance because I had on a brown belt with black shoes, and you pointed that out in front of the crowd. So thanks for that.
I said that out loud.
You did.
My bad.
The Chargers ready to take over.
And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
A running play there. Going to get 10 and a quick first down.
That's the way
have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now a give to Breida. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
On first down, here's Breida. And some room to run now. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Matt Breida, his first touchdown on the year. And the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
Well, I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Another attempt now from 5 yards further back. And an important one that is, as we are tied now early in this fourth quarter. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And it was Matt Breida who had the touchdown run to put an end to it.
Mike Badgley to kick off for the Chargers.
17-17 the score. All even to this point as the kick's away. And this carries into the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 20.
Out now comes the Houston offense as you take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. And right now they're in that number 2 spot. They would love to hold on to that, but obviously first things first. They want to clinch the division.
And that's what everyone plays for. Win your division first, guarantees you a spot in the playoffs. But still, a nice spot to be in. Not as good as it was when the number 2 seed met a first round bye. That's all changed with the new playoff system. But still, a nice spot to be in.
Drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Second and 12, Watson completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big game downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
Throwing on third down, Watson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. Going to be a 43-yard punt, just a single yard on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Chargers getting set to go. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. They'll start on the ground with Breida. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage. And that's a nice pickup on the first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
On the handoff, this is Breida. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Justin Reed, the safety, made the tackle.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the 2-minute warning. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Third and medium, they opted to run instead of pass, and it worked. First down, and down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
Bernard Grant. Short gain, last two plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense, they're saying go right ahead with those.
At their 49-yard line.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Herbert now to throw. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 32-yard line. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now it's Breida. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Once again, they run with Breida on first down. The Texans going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. Here's Breida. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and 4 now. Now the Chargers hustling, trying to get up and get set.
On the play, brings up third and 4.
On third down, a run from Breida. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
4-yard gain. Brings up fourth down. And
so here comes a very important kick now for Michael Badgley.
For the Charger field goal. A 28-yard attempt.
Badgley able to knock this one through. But wait up now. A flag is down. If this is on the defense, they're going to get the first. At each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. From the 2 now, second and goal. They'll try to run with Breida. And he fights his way in for a Charger touchdown. Matt Breida with 9 seconds remaining. And the Chargers are going to take the lead.
And that score in this time frame, that's like a big reveal at the end of a great movie, isn't it? It appears they get it done. How about that score?
Finishes like this. This is why we love sports. This is why we love the game of football.
So glad that we got to be here to watch this one.
Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense and making an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short in the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover in their bases. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Chargers 24.
Well, Charles, this one's going to be hard to digest. You take the lead into the fourth quarter, lose that lead. Maybe they felt like they let this one slip away a little bit.
They will definitely feel like that because when you have a lead in the fourth quarter, all you talk about doing is finishing and